Okay, so here's some practical matters, Michael. I mentioned one of them before, and that is that Mimic does well with structure. When the optimal values that you care about depend only on the structure as opposed to specific values, Mimic tends to do pretty well. By contrast, randomized hill climbing, genetic algorithms, these other things that we looked at before can sometimes get confused by two different values that are both optima but look very different from one another, where it's the structure that matters and not the actual values. So the chain example before, where you had alternating values, is one of those cases where it's easy for randomized algorithms that only look for point values to get confused because they're basically being drawn in multiple directions at once. The quiz also brought up another point, which is worth mentioning here with Mimic and with anything that tries to do this kind of search through probability space, is that it's an issue of representing everything. That is, it's not enough just to be able to represent a probability distribution of the optima. You really want to be able to represent everything in between. As you move through probability space towards your answer, this is the universal symbol for moving through probability space. You don't just want to represent here at the end and here at the beginning, which is pretty easy because it's a uniform distribution. But can you represent this point? Can you represent this point? And if you can't, are you going to end up getting stuck? And it actually turns out that Mimic can get stuck in local optima, though it typically does not, in part because you get randomized restarts for free.
I see.
But the problem of local optima is still a problem of local optima. Now, when I say something like you get randomized restarts for free, I'm actually cheating a little bit and hiding something, which is a little bit more important, which is that what you really get for free is probability theory. So there's a hundreds of years of work on how to think about representing probability distributions and what you can do with them. And there are terms like important sampling and rejection sampling and all these kinds of tools that we have for representing probability distributions that you can actually inherit with something like Mimic for dealing with these painful cases where you might not be able to represent distributions. But the single most important thing to me about Mimic, or what to get out of here, is that representing structure does matter, but you pay a price. And that price basically boils down to time. So the question we might ask ourselves is, what is the sort of practical time complexity of Mimic? And it really boils down to something very simple. Let me just share with you a fact, Michael. Okay? I have run this algorithm on many, many, many examples, and I've compared it to simulated annealing, I've compared it to genetic algorithms, I've compared it to randomized hill climbing, and it works pretty well for the sorts of examples I've come up with. And here's a little fact that I just want to give you. Mimic tends to run orders of magnitude fewer iterations. And I'm not exaggerating here. I mean that if I run simulated annealing, it might take 100,000 iterations for something like simulated annealing, but for Mimic, it might take only 100. And this is consistently true. So it turns out that that's not good enough. It turns out that the fact that Mimic can do something in 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 orders of magnitude fewer iterations isn't an argument for always using it. Can you imagine why not?
Because it might give a worse answer?
Well, in practice, it doesn't. So these are cases where both simulated annealing and Mimic, or randomized hill climbing, or genetic algorithms, actually eventually do find the answer. Mimic just finds it in orders of magnitude fewer iterations.
But you're counting iterations. Mm-hmm. You didn't control for the fact that different algorithms can take different times for a single iteration.
That's exactly right. So what do you think, if I were to compare simulated annealing to Mimic, which do you think takes more time for any given iteration?
Well, simulated annealing just does this little tiny step, right? It like computes a bunch of neighbors and then does a probability comparison and then takes a step. Mimic is drawing this sample, estimating a bunch of parameters, then, I guess the other way around. It's drawing from a distribution. It's computing which things are, say, above the median performance, and then it's re-estimating a new distribution, and then that's the end of the iteration. Depending on how many samples it takes to do that, it could take a very long time, and in particular, it's going to always be a lot more samples than what simulated annealing is doing.
Almost certainly. So when would you think that Mimic would still be worth using in a case like that, where we know that we can get to the answer, but simulated annealing will take orders of magnitude more iterations, Mimic will take fewer iterations? So when would it still be worth it to take the one with fewer iterations, even though each iteration is expensive? Prim's algorithm, quadratic this, that, and the other.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that part.